heard a warning from the woman's page. If you want to keep beautiful, reconcile yourself to hard work and plenty of it. Beauty is a harsh taskmaster.
By the 1960s, Muscle Beach and men's weight training began to come into vogue. And in the 70s, the emergence of the aerobic dance craze brought hundreds of thousands more men and women into the fitness fold. By then, the fitness movement was already 30 years old and heating up. And in the 80s, it exploded.
Cells in my body have never felt better, never been more thrilled than they are right this second.
And I love coming here because the leaders, the innovators in this room inspire me. And for that, I am just so grateful. And
as fit professionals, you know, we're working every day to inspire us, to inspire others, to inspire the people we train. It's an unbelievably fulfilling feeling. And I love that we all just want to build and create so much more in this space.
The way that we can make fitness better, the way that we can heal our communities and really bridge the gap when we talk about inclusion.
The great contribution of IDEA. It has made us conscious that we are a professional industry.
All of a sudden you put me in a room of fitness professionals, my people, my jam, you are my spirit animal. Like I get a little jumpy, so.
You guys all, you know, inspired me to do the best that I could be every single day.
It is your passion and wonderful gift to help others that is truly inspiring the world to fitness.
And I want you to know that your persistence and your observations and your dedication to this industry will pay off.
Fitness requires a strength of body, but more importantly, it requires a strength of soul, because it's a willingness to know yourself from the inside out and to love what you find.
Set the bar high and push yourself to do things beyond what you might imagine are possible right now. It's the only way anything amazing ever happens.
For being a part of this journey, and also we have a lot of work to do in the industry. We all know that while we are improving and getting more people active, there's an incredible amount of work to do. We need to empower more people to fitness, but also more fitness professionals to fitness. So I'll continue to advocate and celebrate with you. Thank you. Culture shock. And they are going to be back at the end of the program. So if you liked that, there's more coming. And we'd also like to thank our sponsor, Send Me a Trainer. They are the sponsor of the opening ceremonies. Let's give it up for Send Me a Trainer. My name is Amy Boone Thompson. I am the very proud owner and CEO of IDEA Health and Fitness. And since acquiring IDEA just a few months ago, I have been asked many questions, but the top two questions I'm asked are, how did you make such a massive acquisition happen so quickly? And there was a lot involved, but mostly a lot of incredibly supportive people who were able to be agile and move quickly. There were tears, there was wine, there were 24-hour sessions, but we did make it happen in a very short amount of time. So there are many people here who are part of that. Thank you. The second question I'm asked most often is, why did you purchase IDEA? And that's the story I'd like to share with you today. It was 1995. I had just graduated from George Mason University as a student athlete, and I was working as a personal trainer and an athletic trainer with my athletic training degree. I was an assistant strength and conditioning coach at George Mason while I was putting myself through sports massage therapy school. Sound familiar? And I got my first job and my first opportunity at the Women's Club in Chantilly, Virginia. It was a beautiful club with childcare and a day spa and Pilates and group fitness and, of course, personal training services. And in those days, and probably still today, new trainers worked what was called a floor shift. And that's where you're offering consultative services to the members in efforts to secure personal training clients. Well, it turns out I loved floor shifts. I could not believe people were actually paying me to talk to people all day long. And so I built my business rather quickly, and I was able to fill my books, and it was simply by just meeting people, being authentic, and offering my support. And because I was so willing and eager, again, I grew my business really quickly. But the best memories I have from my first job in the industry and from the Women's Club are the clients that I trained. In fact, this book contains the profiles, the pictures, and the success stories of each of the beautiful women who trusted me to facilitate their fitness and wellness journey all those years ago. And I keep this book, one, because I had to rebuild my business a few times when I moved to California, but mostly because it was so incredibly inspiring for me. I knew that I was a part of their journey and that through their challenges and their successes and their tears and their hopes, I was able to be alongside them in that journey, and I knew I was creating impact and I was making a difference. And that's why I chose to continue as a personal trainer for so many years. In fact, it's the reason I'm standing here today. That experience and those clients and all of those years ago, all those beautiful women inspired me so deeply and so profoundly that I knew fitness, wellness, and sports industry was exactly where I needed to be. And I knew I could create lasting impact for others. And way back then, I realized the power of just one personal trainer. This is my story, but I'm positive so many of you have similar stories of a club or a client or a place where you were able to make impact. And in fact, I believe that's what connects us all, and that's why we're all here today. IDEA's founders started this association as a grassroots effort based on one basic premise, that by fostering professionalism in the health and fitness industry, millions of people around the world could live healthier, happier lives. And to this day, that philosophy still is what drives our business. And I want to take a moment to thank our founders for their vision in bringing this community together back in 1982. Peter Davis, please stand. Thank you. And Kathy's unable to be here today. She sends her love, and she wishes she could be here, but she's caring for her mother. So we send our love to her. And today, IDEA Health and Fitness is in over 80 countries, and we have hundreds of thousands of members. So the vision has come forward so many times over. And in fact, we have held regional events like this in Shanghai, China, and in Seoul, Korea. And we have a large group of our friends from Seoul, Korea here today, who are professors, who are presenters, who are suppliers, and who are really working with us to bring our vision to life globally. So please help me give a warm welcome to our CEO of IDEA Korea, Jane Jeon. I had the pleasure of visiting Jane in Korea, and I hope you all get a chance to meet her while you're here. So after 40 years, it is only fitting that IDEA has come full circle, and it's back to being a family-owned business, and it will be here for many more years to come as a platform for all of us. This family business, and really none of this, to be honest, is possible without these four people. So I would like Sean, Nia, Boone, and my mother-in-law, Regina, please stand. They've been coming to IDEA since, well, the only IDEA conferences I missed was when I was pregnant with the two of them. So they've been coming in strollers and as they were toddlers, and now they get to be part of IDEA forever. So truly, IDEA has thrived for 40 plus years because it belongs to all of us. It brings together a community of like-minded people who set the bar as high as possible for our profession, and who are committed to the collective success of every professional in the world. Now and in the future, you can expect IDEA to continue to lead by our core values and IDEA's code of ethics. You can expect IDEA to lead advocacy for essentialism, to secure our place in the healthcare continuum, and to work for you, the practitioner. And IDEA is leading efforts toward a more diverse and equitable profession where there are no isms and there are no phobias. And where every professional and every human has access to the gifts of health and wellness. And only then can we really inspire the entire world to fitness. We are here for 4 days of fun and of sweating and of learning and of growing. But above all else, we are here to create human connection. Let's face it, you all could have stayed at home and done more online versions of training, right? So while we are here, make it a point to build personal connections and create new experiences together. Everything you need to rebuild your business, to grow your career, is right here in this room and right in the expo. And all you have to do is be open. Be open to building more connections and to meeting people, and that truly will help you and support you in your career. And as we kick off this event, I'd like to acknowledge briefly, but profoundly, that all of us have experienced tremendous change in the last couple of years, and loss in our families and of our businesses, and we've seen immense and intense change over the last couple of years. And that's why this week is a very important milestone in our rebuilding and our healing process. And the fact that you're here to share in this healing process says a lot about you and who you are, and the fact, again, that you're open to building connection and moving forward. So in celebration, of our 40th anniversary and of inspiring the world to fitness, I'm thrilled to be here with all of you. And I want you to remember, as we look forward to all the opportunities and possibilities, I want you to remember that I am limitless and you are limitless. And together, we are limitless. Now, as you know, over the last couple of years, we were forced to have virtual events. And in those virtual events, we did give out our esteemed awards. And those individuals were celebrated not only because of their contributions throughout their career, but specifically during the pandemic, these individuals really shined to help our communities and really the entire industry. So at this point in time, I want to give them their long overdue round of applause. Leslie Bender, Trisha Murphy, Madden, Jeffrey Scott, please stand.
Thank you.